Myself, Dr. K.B. Sangve, Associate Professor, Brijlal Biyani Science College, Amravati, affiliated to Sant Gadge Baba Amravati University, Amravati. Today, we are going to discuss about food chain and food web. This topic is included in the syllabus of BSc second year, semester 4, unit number 6. So, today's learning objective are, we are going to learn today what is food chain, in that introduction about this, definition of food chain and food web, components of food chain and types of food chain, and lastly we will see the difference between food chain and food web. So introduction, the food chain refers to the order of events in an ecosystem where one living organism eats another organism and later that organism is consumed by other larger organism. The flow of nutrients and energy from one organism to another at different trophic levels forms a food chain. The food chain also explains the feeding pattern of relationship between living organism. Trophic level refers to the sequential stage in a food chain, starting with producers at the base, followed by the primary, secondary and tertiary consumers. Every level in a food chain is known as trophic level. Definition: one can define food chain as the sequence of transfer of matter and energy in the form of food from organism to organism is called as food chain. It is a network or the link between producers, consumers, decomposers and again to the producers. The same things can be explained in another fashion, that is food from autotrophs transferred to the herbivores and from herbivores eaten up by the carnivorous animals, and these carnivores when after the death they are decomposed or utilized by the detritivorous animals. Definition of food web, one can define many food chains when come together or forms a complex, and that complex system is known as food web, or when many such individual food chains occur in an ecosystem, it is known as food web. So this diagram represents, so there are the different trophic levels including producers, which includes plants. From these plants the energy is produced with the help of sun by the process of photosynthesis. This energy is transferred to the herbivorous animals. Here example is frog, and that frog is a consumer that depend upon the green plants, and these herbivorous animals, they are eaten up by the carnivorous animals. Here there is an example of fox, and the energy is transferred to the fox. So there is a transfer of energy from producers, consumer and the secondary consumers, or from the herbivorous, from the producers to the herbivorous animals and to the carnivorous animals. And after the death of these secondary consumers or the tertiary consumers, they are decomposed by the decomposers, and this organic matter is decomposed or detritivores utilized. After the utilization of detritivorous animals, they are converted into inorganic material, and these inorganic material is again penetrated or inserted into the soil or transfer into the soil, and from this soil these soil nutrients is again utilized by the plants, and our plants again forms the energy. In this fashion the energy is passing from one trophic level to the another trophic levels, in that energy is neither created or nor destroyed. In this fashion the energy is continuously goes on passing. So this diagram shows the terrestrial chain of ecosystem. Then components of food chain. The sun is the main source of energy which produces the energy. Producers, this is the first stage in a food chain. They utilize the energy from the sun to make the food. They are also known as autotrophs, as they make their own food. For example, algae, green plants, etc. Consumers, this is the second and the largest stage of the food chain. They depend on the plants or other organism for food. It includes herbivores which eats plants, carnivores which eat other animals, while the scavengers eat the dead animals. Decomposers, this is the third and the last stage of the food chain. They get energy from the dead and decaying organic materials. They convert organic waste into inorganic materials like nutrient-rich soil or land that can be utilized by the producers. Then the types of food chain. So there are main two types, grazing type of food chain or detritus food chain. In grazing food chain, the food that starts with green plants passes through herbivores and then to carnivores. In a grazing food chain, energy in the lowest tropical level is acquired from photosynthesis. Detritus food chain includes different species of organism and plants like algae, bacteria, fungi, protozoa, mites, insects, worms, and so on. The detritus food chain begins with dead organic material. The food energy passes into decomposers and detritivores, which are further eaten up by small organisms like carnivores. Carnivores like maggots become a meal for bigger carnivore like frog, snake, and so on. Primary consumers like fungi, bacteria, protozoans, and so on are detritivores which feed on detritus. Then difference between food chain and food web. A food chain followed a single path where animal discovered them, but a food web shows different path where the plants and animals are connected. A food web comprises several food chains. In food chain, an organism eat a single item, whereas in food web, an organism consume multiple items. In a food chain, there is a singular path for energy flow, and in food web, there is a different path of energy flow. Stay at home, stay safe. Thanks for watching. Thank you. Thank you very much.